This is the 80th anniversary of the attack on Pearl Harbor, and a special military unit just finished a multi-year project to identify the remains of hundreds who died during the attack on the USS Oklahoma. I visited the lab near Omaha, Nebraska recently, where scientists conducted that work, and I found while that project is complete, they never give up on finding and identifying others who died in service to our country.
It's right over here.
In the town of Monette, the name Tom Wolfe is everywhere. It's on a highway sign.
It hit the community of Monette hard.
It's on a building, and his name is on a plaque in a cemetery. Tom Wolfe, the pilot shot down in Cambodia in 1966, is definitely not forgotten.
Hopefully, the good people who are trying to find all of the unknowns and get them identified will find him.
So this would just be kind of a basic cleaning.
If and when Tom is found, people like Dr. Sarah Kinshew will identify him.
This particular piece is part of the boot sole.
Sarah is a forensic anthropologist. Her current work involves an unknown from World War II. His bomber went down in Germany.
So the material here on the table is what we would consider to be material evidence, meaning it was something that a service member would have been wearing or would have had in their pockets, would have had on their person at the time that they died.
The evidence includes a knife, a belt buckle, part of his flight suit, and even a Bible burned all around the edges. Now, there is one area we're not going to show you. The military won't allow us to show it to you. We want to respect the wishes of family members. Right back here, there's a lab with human remains.
You know, I see these items on these tables, and I know that they are going to go back to a family, and it will mean a lot to them. And so for us, that's very important.
The lab is inside Offutt Air Force Base near Omaha, Nebraska. The scientists here just finished identifying 355 service members from the sinking of the USS Oklahoma in Pearl Harbor. The project involved 13,000 bones. It took 6 years.
The motto of the agency is fulfilling a nation's promise. And it is a promise to the service member. Maybe even 80 years ago in the case of the USS Oklahoma, the sailors and the Marines that we've been identifying.
And military scientists in a sister lab recently identified the remains of Army Sergeant John Phillips, the World War II Cassville native, just buried in Arlington in September.
September 17th is National POW MIA Recognition Day across the country. For us, every day is Recognition Day. And there's not a day that we don't have our scientists in the lab working on cases.
We need to be able to see all of the little features and details.
For Sarah, the stitching on the boot is a clue. The coils and the heated flight jacket, and in this case, some shiny metal on a shirt.
His navigator wings are actually still attached to his service shirt. So that's probably the most important item here because it specifically identifies that shirt as going to one person.
She's been working on this case since July.
It does say U.S. Army, but it's so worn here that it's just barely written right there.
She'll start writing reports soon. A family could be notified of an identification a few months from now.
The technology that we have today is a great thing.
Hours away from Sarah's lab, Jason George regrets one thing, that time is not endless for those waiting for answers.
It's most important for the families. Having known Tom's mother, Yana, she wanted so badly for Tom's body to be identified and brought back home before she passed away, and it's a shame that that didn't happen.
Until he's found, Jason and others honor Tom Wolfe, keeping his name front and center, definitely not forgotten.
Hopefully, we'll find him, and one day he'll be able to be interred here.
We're staying in touch with the lab, and when they identify the remains and notify the family of that World War II navigator, we'll let you know his identity, too.